Turn 44. Is that correctly remember? Yeah, that's turn 44. Late January 63. I am going to let Sherman assault now. He actually gets Burnside comes in to support him also with supplies. But even if we are okay doing supply, we have enough supplies. But I'm just in case this thing gets drawn out. Sheridan is okay with supplies. I'm getting two divisions back from Crittenden's corps to join Butler, who will then be available to support in case this assault fails. But with the forces they have in here, I don't think they can withstand this assault. Unless, I mean, I could also do it with Sheridan, just move Sheridan in and do the assault. But I'll do it like this. I'm also preparing, I have one more division coming out here. I just need to have the troops trained first. Don't he's Halleck is handling some. Oh, see, just like this, and then this. But I want a full strength before I let him go into the fighting. And also, I am get still a couple of turns away from getting the black the colored divisions. I don't think that will be necessary because I don't think they can withstand that assault unless for some by some magic. By some miraculous way, Longstreet manages to actually get back and liberate Richmond from the assault from the siege. I just don't see how he can do that. Oh, he is actually moving. So he is coming in to try and I mean that would also make sense to do that, but it's just. Sherman already has entrenchment here, so. As soon as we get into one day into the turn, there's just reinforcement to go I went over and took the other fort. Oh, I am assaulting the other fort, but they haven't arrived yet. That's a Hooker's call. Now you can see Burnside has joined Sherman. So now we're assaulting. That's just a little assault here on. I did with that little call I made, just to secure, Sherman's left flank. Can just imagine that they land a call and then they sneak up and take Alexandria. What the hell? Didn't even get an assault, they just surrendered. That's what I prefer. Well, that's the Admiral. Is he? Now, what's in Richmond? I can't even. Oh, I took Richmond. That's now. There was Sherman ready for us to assault Richmond, but we didn't have to do it. I'm actually quite happy about that. So you have three strong cores just adjacent. So we didn't even get to use the. Oh, I didn't even notice that one. That's probably a copperhead. No, that's a militia. So they made this the equivalent of. Oh, is it a copperhead? No, it's either that thing, unionist is my version of it. Okay, let's just take a look at the numbers here. Zero morale. They have 25% of our military strength, which is quite a lot when you think about it, because they have a much smaller area. I wonder where the hell all that force is. Combat losses, you can see they're taking three times as many casualties as I have. And they actually had a bit of, I mean, we took what, 6,000 on Richmond, which is quite low, but it's quite a lot compared to what we had already. No, not really. But most of their combat losses have been from just getting stomped by Grant again and again in this offensive over here. Paved the way for this. And of course it was also that we got a good general in charge of it instead of either McClellan or crappy McDowell. He's getting boosted by Sherman. I hope you enjoyed it. Let's see, is there anything else we should be looking at? What's our morale? It's 188. Oh, we're actually above the wind level, so we didn't even need to do the knockout blow here. I mean, it is a knockout blow that I'm doing here because this is what it says when you start the game. If you can capture Richmond, Vicksburg, Memphis, and New Orleans, I think it is. That's, of course, also why you launched the offensive. Well, not the only reason, but it's one of the reasons why you launched an offensive with Grant. To go for this, and then you take Richmond, and they're done. I hope you enjoyed watching this as much as I enjoyed playing it. Goodbye.